Mr. West Dickens.
Ah, Mr. Marston. How wonderful to see you, sir. How wonderful.
Are we ready, then?
Yes, sir. Nearly, sir. Barely nearly, sir. I just need some cash to get some extra hardware fitted to my old Trojan horse here.
You what?
Never mind, sir. I can only presume that you have not enjoyed the benefits of a classical education, so I will not take umbrage if some of my illusions sail over your head, sir.
I won't pretend to understand you, but I will endeavor to make you understand me. Either we do this right now, or I put a bullet in you and get on with my day.
Please, I knew you were a violent man, Mr. Marston, but I did not think you were a stupid one. We need money to outfit my carriage, to turn a simple tradesman's vehicle into something more subterfuge. And I'm about to tell you how we are going to gain said cash. Now I know that you ride very well. So come, sir, to Rathskeller Fork!
Follow me, John! It's not too far to Rathskeller Fork! So how are you, John?
Okay, all things considered. Hopefully we can get through today without running into another army of your satisfied customers.
Onwards and upwards! I refuse to let the blind stupidity of the proletariat derail my calling in life.
Nothing blind about it. I'd say they saw right through you.
Before knowledge comes doubt, my dear boy.
Everybody knows you're as crooked as a dog's hind leg, Wes Dickens.
I resent that implication, John.
I wasn't implying. I was telling. If you're such a successful businessman, what are you doing living in a cave?
Delightfully Dickensian, isn't it?
If you say so.
Are you familiar with the concept of philanthropy, John?
I'm surprised you are.
Oh, I don't do any of this for myself, John. I hope you realize that. It's been quite a ride, John, hasn't it?
We haven't gone that far.
No, I mean us. Fitchwood Farm, Gaptooth Creek, Plainview. We make quite a team, you and me. Brains and brawn. We should consider a more permanent partnership.
This partnership ends as soon as I have Bill Williamson. I appreciate your help, but I've just about had it with all your schemes. You need to realize what's at stake here.
I know, John, I know. Just win this race and we'll be ready. I give you my word. There's Rathskeller Fork up ahead.
Gentlemen, this will be a fair race. No shooting, stabbing, cliff pushing, rock throwing, cactus grinding, neck lassoing, setting fires, or other acts that causes a rider to unfairly lose his weight or bleed heavily or black out. Get yourselves ready. Set. Go.
Yeah.
No.
That's it. Get back. Let's go.
conquered. What a fantastic spectacle, John. Let's take a moment to bask in the glory of our victory.
Have we got enough money now?
All right. Yes, once Seth and Irish have furnished their side of the bargain, I think we should be ready. Quite a team we've assembled, don't you think?
A bunco, a grave robber, and a drunk. How could things possibly go wrong?
Hey there.